Around 100 years ago, galaxies as we know them didn't exist. Back in the day, astronomer Edwin Hubble used a relation developed and discovered by Henrietta Swan Leavitt, who was one of the Harvard computers at Harvard Observatory. She had discovered this particular type of star that would get bright and go dim and get bright and go dim over certain periods of time. And the amount of time it would take for a particular star to go bright, then dim, then bright again would indicate exactly how bright it is. And you could use that brightness to measure distances to stars in the Milky Way or outside of the Milky Way very accurately. These stars are called Cepheid variable stars, and Edwin Hubble looked at Cepheid variable stars in the Andromeda Nebula to measure its distance away. But when he measured these stars, he realized that these stars were a lot further away than what was expected, like beyond thousands of light years to millions of light years away, completely changing our understanding of the universe at that time, because at that time we thought the Milky Way was it. That was the entire universe. And you may have clued in that the Andromeda Nebula is actually the Andromeda Galaxy as we know it today. So Edwin Hubble, looking at these stars using the relation developed by Henrietta Swan Leavitt, discovered the first galaxy outside the Milky Way 100 years ago. Since then, we've observed many more galaxies, or realized that we've been observing many more galaxies, and Hubble categorized galaxies into two general types. You've got your flat spiral galaxies and your blobby elliptical galaxies. And with the development of more and more powerful telescopes like the Hubble Space Telescope, named after Edwin Hubble, and JWST, we're seeing thousands of galaxies in the Hubble Deep Field. Tens of thousands of galaxies in the Hubble Ultra Deep Field, and even more galaxies than we could possibly imagine in Webb's first deep field. Which just goes to show that there are trillions upon trillions of galaxies out there in the universe for us to discover. And with that many galaxies, there are bound to be some weird ones out there. And that's what today's video is about. Five of what I think are the weirdest galaxies in the universe. Let's get into them. First up is my absolute favorite galaxy in the entire universe. This is M64, or the Black Eye Galaxy, which gets its name because it has a bright nucleus at the center, which looks like an eye, and this dark, blobby, gassy stuff on the outside that makes it look like the bruised under eye of a black eye. But now this one is really interesting for one particular reason, and it's not just because it looks pretty, but this gassy outer disk actually spins in the opposite direction to the gas and the stars in the inner parts of this galaxy. So the inside spins one way, while this dark outer black eye part spins in the opposite direction, which is just weird. Very unusual. And the cause of this counter-rotation is not yet fully understood, but what might be the case is that this galaxy recently absorbed another galaxy. Yes, galaxies can merge into each other because of gravity being dominant on the scales of where galaxies are. Yes, the universe is expanding, but if you're close enough, gravity is dominant. So this counter-rotation is likely due to this galaxy absorbing another galaxy about a billion years ago. And due to the interaction between these counter-rotating disks of gas, there's actually some star formation happening, which you can see in these blue and pink patches within the dark black eye part of this galaxy. But now onto one that's a bit more mysterious that we don't really have a definitive answer for yet. That is NGC 474. Now this one is a giant elliptical galaxy. It's about 2.5 times the size of the Milky Way. And unlike most elliptical galaxies, this one has some shells or rings around it. And only 10% of elliptical galaxies actually have shells like this, so it's a very rare thing to see. The reason behind why these shells exist is still yet to be determined. It could be the after effects of this large galaxy absorbing multiple smaller galaxies over time. It also could have collided with a much larger galaxy and caused ripples to go through it, kind of like throwing a pebble into water and ripples kind of come out. That might be the case. And it also could be because of the absorption of a more gas-rich galaxy. So a galaxy that has more gas to make stars in it. Those are three scenarios. They all kind of tangle around galaxy collisions, but the source of this ring and shell-like stuff is really unknown, which makes it very peculiar and interesting to me. Now moving on to a very pretty galaxy. It's the Southern Pinwheel Galaxy, which looks relatively normal as far as galaxies go, but it is a very peculiar one. For starters, this galaxy has 6 known supernovae. We've seen 6 stars go supernova in this galaxy. That is more than any other galaxy we've seen so far, I think. There might be some that are up there as well, but that is a lot of supernovas for us to see in the last century, in one galaxy. And you may notice that there are these pinky, bluey, splotchy things all throughout this galaxy, very similar to the Black Eye Galaxy, that is also where stars are being formed within this galaxy. It has a very high star formation rate. But what really sets this galaxy apart for what makes it weird is that it has two centers. Now, that doesn't mean that there are two supermassive black holes at the center of this galaxy. As far as we know, that there is just one supermassive black hole at the center of this galaxy. But what's likely the case here is that you have the supermassive black hole and then this lopsided disk orbiting around that supermassive black hole that makes it look like it has two cores. And the reason behind this is, you probably guessed it, a likely merger that has happened in the last couple billion years. And these two apparent cores are likely and expected to merge within 60 million years. So really not that long in comparison to the other timescales we've said today. Now, I've saved one of the best for almost the last because Hoag's object is just so rare and weird. This is the most perfect ring galaxy in the universe that we've found so far. And ring galaxies in themselves are super rare. And fun fact, this galaxy was actually originally mistaken to be a planetary nebula, which is what gets left over when a star like our sun dies. But alas, no, it is not the death of a sun-like star, it is many more stars in a ring around what looks like another galaxy. So what are you actually seeing here? Well, you've got this ring of hot blue young stars surrounding a yellowish core of older stars. And the formation of Hoag's object is still under debate. Its founder, Hoag, originally thought that it was a gravitational lensing event after he didn't think that it was a planetary nebula, but I digress. He thought it was from gravitational lensing, but that is not possible because when you look at the distances to the stars at the center, in the yellow part, and the stars of the blue ring around it, they had the same distance. So they're actually not far away from each other in the same spot in space. So no gravitational lensing on that part. Once again, it could also be the result of a galaxy collision, where a smaller galaxy could have collided with a bigger galaxy, leaving this ring shape around it as well. But that is hard to believe fully because there would be other signs showing us that there was a collision recently, like tidal tails or other merging effects like that. So the evidence for that scenario is kind of lacking. And finally, it could also be from a recent accretion event, but there's also features that are missing from the galaxy that would explain that as well. So who knows how this was made? We're still trying to figure it out. But here's a little fun thing. If you look in about 1 o'clock on Hoag's object, you'll find another almost perfect ring galaxy just hiding in the background. How rare is that to find not one, but two of the most rarest galaxies in the universe that we know of so far? That is truly wild, and what makes me love this object so much. And finally, another galaxy that I really enjoy, it's one of my favorites, not quite as high up as the Black Eye Galaxy, but this one is pretty high up there too. And it is very peculiar because it evades classification. It has characteristics that make it an elliptical galaxy, but it also has characteristics that make it a spiral galaxy. It's somewhere in between. This is the Sombrero Galaxy, because it kind of looks like a sombrero, much like the Black Eye Galaxy looks kind of like a black eye. But the characteristics that make this galaxy look like a spiral galaxy is this thin disk of dust and stars that is, well, quite like a disk, but then it has this quite large bulge of stars that look a lot like elliptical galaxies, and it also, the stars in that big bulge dominate the mass and the luminosity of this galaxy, which leads us more to that elliptical side. So is it spiral? Is it elliptical? ¿Por qué no los dos? It is both. It's also a relatively isolated galaxy. Unlike the Milky Way, we've got quite a few companions, some galactic neighbors around us. We've got the small and large Magellanic clouds that orbit around the Milky Way, we think. There's still some debate happening there. We've got the Andromeda Galaxy that's not too far away from us and getting closer every single second. But the point is that there's a lot of neighbors around us in the Milky Way. The Sombrero Galaxy doesn't have a lot of neighbors, which may lead to why it's so inactive in its star formation and its supermassive black hole at the center is also relatively quiet. And that may be due to a lack of neighbors. It's a bit of a hermit of galaxies. But I am so happy because JWST took a photo of this galaxy recently and it looks super cool and it reveals details that we hadn't seen before. So first things first, when you see this JWST image, the bulge stars almost completely disappear. And that's because JWST sees infrared light, and those stars are less bright at infrared than they are in the visible wavelengths that Hubble sees in its photo. So they just disappear more or less out of the JWST image, revealing more details within the disk part, the spiral galaxy characteristic of the Sombrero Galaxy. Now this image reveals new details that we haven't seen before, like a smooth inner disk that was originally shrouded behind all the light from these big bulgy stars. And also there are these bubbly, bulgy bits in the outer disk, which is likely a sign of star formation, which is super cool. But there you go, that is just five of the trillions upon trillions upon trillions of galaxies that exist out there in the universe that I think are the weirdest ones of the universe. Drop a comment and let me know if you thought they were also weird, or if there were even weirder ones that I missed out of my list, because there's just too many galaxies out there.